Welcome to the Community Shall Be Restored. I'm your host, Prophet Cedric Banks, along with
Prophetess Dianetta Banks.
All right, we have a very, very exciting show today that's going to be a blessing to your life. Pastor Dianetta, just go right ahead.
Amen. Well, we would like to welcome you out to our church, the Heart of Jesus International Deliverance Church. We're located at 14111 East 7 Mile Road. That's right at the corner of 7 Mile and Gratiot. We're inside the WOW Center, and that's located right behind Mike's Market. Our service times is at 2 p.m. And we want you to come out and just be blessed of the Lord, because our apostle, he moves mightily in the gifts of the Spirit, mightily in prophecy, mightily in miracles. And the word is practical, where it'll help equip you, amen, in your walk with the Lord. So our service time is at 2 p.m. and we welcome you to come out. And on this Resurrection Sunday, on March the 27th, our apostle has brought out Bishop Wayne T. Jackson, son of 23 years and counting, amen, Pastor Warren.
His wife, Pastor Yvette Warren, who works in prophecy. So that's going to be a prophecy miracle healing service.
Amen.
On Resurrection Sunday at the Heart of Jesus Church. And that's at 14111 East 7 Mile, 7 Mile and Gratiot, right behind Mike's Market. That is going to be, so come out and be blessed by that service. And we got one more thing.
Amen. And you can Google Prophet Cedric Banks to find out more about his ministry. Amen. You just go to Google and Prophet Cedric Banks. Type in Prophet Cedric Banks. Also, if you've missed any of our prior episodes, they're all located, amen, on the YouTube network. You go to youtube.com/CedricBanks4Detroit. 4 is the number 4. So if you missed any other programs, you can see a lot about the different programs, all the different guests that Prophet has had on, from Councilman James Tate to Sherry, U.S. Representative Sherry Gay Dagnago, and so many others. You can go to youtube.com/CedricBanks4Detroit.
The young lady, the councilman in District 6, Lopez, was here. Councilman Andre Spivey, Detroit City Councilman Andre Spivey. You can see on that network, on that YouTube network. Sherry Gay Dagnago, state representative. We got Rosemary Robinson, state representative, district number 6 next. No, not 6, number 4. I'm sorry. Rosemary Robinson, district number 4. Let's go to a commercial break. We'll be right back.
Song says, I do. Let's say that again. I really do.
All right, back from break. We have a wonderful guest here that's doing some great, great things out in the District 6 area. In District 6, doing some great things. Let's welcome Stephanie Chang, State Representative, District Number 6.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
Oh, you're welcome. You're welcome. You're welcome. Stephanie, where is District 6? Where is the boundaries of District 6 for those that's out there in TV land wanting to know? And there's a lot of people that already know where it's at.
Okay.
But then there may be a lot of people that don't know where it's at, but they may, after they hear that, they may say, oh, wow, guess what?
Okay.
That's my area.
Yeah, absolutely. So I love my district. It's so House District 6 is a nice strip along the Detroit River. So starting over in Indian Village, actually, through the villages, through downtown, and then part of Southwest Detroit, and all of River Rouge and all of Ecorse as well.
Okay.
Yeah.
All righty. All right. Wonderful. Wonderful. So, what are some of the things that some of your goals and what are you building? What are you trying to do in District 6?
Yeah. Well, there's a lot that we're working on. You know, I took office in January 2015.
Okay.
So it's been about a year and a couple months. Mm-hmm. And there's a lot that I'm doing in Lansing, and then there's also a lot that I'm doing in the district. So starting with what I'm doing in the district, we actually have a neighborhood service center where we're doing a lot of really wonderful projects and where people can come in 9 to 5, Monday through Friday, with whatever things they might need. We'll try to do the best we can, whether it be...
Where is that located at? Yeah. If I want to come there and be a part, you mean I can come there from 9 to 5? Monday
oh, absolutely. Yep.
Where is it at? Will I have a voice when I come?
Yes.
I mean, are you going to listen to me?
Absolutely.
Okay.
It's 1927 Rosa Parks Avenue, or Boulevard, and it's 2 blocks south of Michigan Avenue. So it's a great place, and we have staff both from my office and Raquel Castaneda Lopez's office together, so it's a joint combined effort. But in addition to providing services, whether it be reconnecting, you know, someone's DHS benefits or helping with utilities, or we also do a lot of wonderful things like right now, helping prevent tax foreclosures. So getting out in the community, going door to door, and then having people call us as follow up to make sure that we're connecting people with different payment plans so that we can help save people's homes.
So you help people with utilities?
Mm-hmm.
You do? Wow.
Yeah.
Well, wow, that's great. That's great to know. How can people get in touch with you?
Yeah.
Is there a phone number, an email, a Gmail, a Cmail, a Bmail, or anything? How can they get in?
Yeah.
Because I'm just see people want to get in contact with you.
Oh, good.
Want to call you.
Absolutely. Well, our district office, our neighborhood service center phone number is 313-841-2240. And then a good email is just my name, Stephanie Chang, at house.mi.gov. And we also have a Lansing office where obviously we're doing a lot up there as well. And that number is 517-373-0823.
Okay, we're here today with State Representative, District Number 6, Stephanie Chang. And we had a young lady, or was a young lady on the show, and I think she said you all share offices. She was just here a couple weeks ago.
Oh, good. Raquel Lopez.
Yep. Lopez, City Council. Yeah. Mm-hmm. She was just here a couple weeks ago.
Oh, good.
Raquel Lopez. Right. And that's great to see a state rep and a city council woman sharing offices and things.
You know, it makes sense.
That's really great.
Yeah. We
all working together.
We're working together. I'm all about collaboration. I also have a great relationship with council member Sheffield, since I also overlap with her district. And so I'm all about working together, and especially because sometimes if someone calls our office and they might have a city issue, then we can handle that through Raquel's office. Or if someone calls with a state issue, then my office can help. So it's nice to have that one phone number, and people come with whatever issue that might be, and then we'll try to do the best we can.
Do you have any meetings going on, like monthly meetings every other month or monthly, where the community can get out and get involved more in the community and ask questions and be in participation? And if you do, where are these meetings and what time and what day are these meetings would take place?
Sure. So we do a number of different meetings. So actually just this morning we had a coffee hour at Clark Park, and last week we were in Ecorse, and next Friday from 3 to 4:30.
What goes on? Now, is this a regular thing, the coffee hour?
Yeah, so it's not regularly scheduled, but you can always call us to find out when the next one is, or go to our website.
Yeah.
We try to do them whenever we can. Last fall, we did a bunch of them at the senior buildings, because you know that sometimes seniors may not come out to the coffee shop, but they, if we come to them. So, but the next one's actually next Friday, the 18th.
from 3 to 4:30 at Germack Coffee in Eastern Market.
What all takes place during the coffee hour? Tell me some of the things what takes place, and let the community look right there in that camera, and let the community know what takes place during the coffee hour when these events are going forward.
Well, the coffee hours are a really great opportunity, mostly for me to listen and to provide updates about what's going on in Lansing, to hear from you about whatever issue it might be. This morning at the coffee hour, we heard about it. We talked about education. We talked about historic districts and a bill that's a Republican bill that's trying to change that. We talked about biking. We talked about school safety. So whatever issue it is that you want to talk about, those coffee hours are a really great way to come and share that with me.
How many people are you getting out during coffee hour? I mean, are people coming out? Are they participating? How many people, how many people are you getting out during the time of coffee hour?
Well, it really depends on the day. So today I think we probably had about 15, and last week we had about 15.
That's good.
And then, obviously, when we do it at like a senior building, we get a big crowd and bring some cookies and donuts and fruit and that sort of thing, and the seniors all come down and we have a good time. So depends on the location, but I love doing coffee hours because sometimes I know that, well, we do love people coming into our office, but if in case you can't, then we'll come out to you and do the coffee hours too.
Okay, now is this the coffee hour, what's going forward, is it impacting lives in the community? Is it making a difference? Do you feel that you are impacting the people's life or making a difference with the people who's showing up?
Sure, yeah. Well, I think so, because a lot of times people will come and they'll bring up an issue that maybe I hadn't heard about, or they'll talk about something that's also I'm really passionate about, and then that whatever information they might share with me, then I'll be able to take with me to my work in Lansing or to different projects that are going on. So just as an example, we were doing coffee hours last fall at senior buildings in District 6, and one of the seniors at 8330 on the river, she said, why don't we start a senior advisory council? So I said, sure, let's do that. So now we have a House District 6 senior advisory council where we're bringing together the seniors from all the different buildings and the different neighborhoods. We're trying to do more outreach to get more people involved as a way to get together on a quarterly basis to actually tell me about what are the issues affecting seniors so that we can then turn that into potentially legislation or different projects. So this was literally an idea that someone had, and then they gave that to me, and then now we're moving forward.
So the issues that you are getting from the coffee hour and things, you are trying to take these to Lansing.
We try. We are definitely trying. So whether it be a coffee hour or an event, we also do lots of different town halls. We had a town hall last summer about Belle Isle. We had a town hall about paid sick days. I'm the primary sponsor of a bill to make sure that everyone has earned paid sick days so they can, go stay home to get better before they go back to work, so they're not infecting customers. And the idea is that everything should be connected, whether it's the bills that I'm working on in Lansing or the project that I'm doing in my district office and what I'm hearing out in the community. We try to keep it all connected.
Beautiful, beautiful. We're here today with State Representative Stephanie Chang, District Number 6. Pastor Donetta, do you have a question for State Representative Stephanie Chang?
What are some of the concerns that the seniors had then when you met with them that you're looking to make into legislation?
Right. So one of the things that people mentioned was, and I think that this is going to continue to grow as a problem or an issue, is some of the seniors in some of the buildings that they live in have different living conditions that need to be addressed. And also in certain buildings, rent is going up, or some of the HUD contracts for some of these housing units may be expiring. And so this is something I'm starting to look into, is for the places that are currently HUD subsidized housing for seniors, we want to make sure that those seniors have a place to live. And so I think what people are afraid of is what happens if a contract expires and then that gets bought out and then goes to market rate housing, and then seniors might get pushed out, sort of like what happened with downtown. So we were trying, that's something that's on people's radar, especially as sort of downtown and midtown are starting to, you know, grow and grow and grow, and rents are increasing. There's a lot of anxiety that some of the seniors have expressed to me about, well, what does that mean for them? Right. So that's something that I want to look into. You know, what are other states or other cities doing better? Can we do something like maybe grandfathering people in? And the idea is, so if you are over a certain age or you've been in a certain building for over however many years, that you shouldn't be evicted. You know, you shouldn't be evicted if something transitions to a different type of housing. I don't know yet. I'm still doing the research and doing some brainstorming. And one of the things that I'm excited about is to hear the ideas too from the Senior Advisory Council, so that they. Seniors have so many great ideas and so much life experience that I think that they'll probably have a lot that they want to share with me that I can turn into some actions.
Wonderful. Excellent. If you have a question today for State Representative Stephanie Chang, District Number 6, give us a call here at 313-868-4336. We're live here today with State Representative Stephanie Chang. From District Number 6. You know, it's a beautiful thing that you're taking this, you're having these coffee shop meetings and you're taking these things, you're taking the concerns back to Lansing and trying to make a difference. And that is really, really a beautiful thing because a lot of times many of our seniors have been forgotten about.
Mm-hmm.
They've been forgotten about by family, friends, has tossed them and threw them up under the bus. But we thank God for community leaders like yourself who has a heart for the seniors and that's trying to make a difference in their life. When is the next community meeting, Stephanie, that you have?
The next Senior Advisory Council meeting, I believe, is April 1st. And so we, in the morning, we haven't locked down the time yet, but it'll be an e-course. There's a e-course senior center. So we will be there. I don't think that we have all the details firmed up, but you can call us at that number. Again, it's 313-841-2240. We'll be sure to keep you in the loop, and because we want to keep this a regular thing. So in addition to the Senior Advisory Council, we also have a safety roundtable. An educator roundtable.
What goes on the safety roundtable? Yeah. What are some of the things that they talk about on the safety roundtable? Because I'm involved in a lot of roundtables in the community.
Great.
I just opened up today for the 14th Congressional in Prayer.
Wonderful.
A place, you see some of my church members, they were with me today, and a place where judges, attorneys, you familiar? I'm pretty sure you probably familiar with that. Yeah, and it'd be packed. And I open up in prayer for them every month during the meetings.
Wonderful.
And also, I'll be sitting on a round table very, very soon with
Judge Deborah Thomas.
Judge Deborah Thomas, wonderful. And the Congresswoman.
And Brenda Lawrence.
Yeah,
great.
So I'll do I do round tables.
That's
so
great.
If you need any. Body else to assist, just get with Teresa there. That's Teresa. Raise your hand. You know Teresa. I'm sure you've been communicating with Teresa.
Thank you.
She's wonderful. Administrator.
Okay.
Yeah. So we're here with Stephanie Chang, District Number 6. Pastor Donetta, what do you think of this? All this great stuff that State Rep Stephanie Chang is doing out there in the community.
I think it's very exciting, and I'm sure it's rewarding to be able to be an assistance to our seniors and bring change to the community as a whole. I'm wondering what other things do you have on the table?
Mm-hmm.
What are some of the goals that you have in the next, you know, the rest of this year?
So there's one of the big areas that I am trying to focus on is related to environmental justice. I think a lot of people know that in Southwest Detroit, the rates of asthma, well, across the city too, the rates of asthma, especially in children, is very, very high. The hospitalization rate of children with asthma is, I forget, is it three? I think it's three times higher than the rest of the state.
Yeah.
And so I think a lot of that is because of the air pollution.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of times people think, you know, the environment, what does that have to do with me? But when it really affects people's lungs, when we see kids with asthma or seniors with asthma, or, you know, when I went door knocking in Southwest Detroit, and that's something I continue to do. And people talk about family members that they've lost due to various forms of cancer, or, you know, themselves having COPD. This is a real issue. Mm-hmm. So air quality is not nothing to, you know, joke about. It's something very, very serious. And so the reason why it's such a big issue in Southwest Detroit is because you've got the Marathon Refinery, you've got a U.S. Steel, you've got DTE has a coal plant, and you have AK Steel in Dearborn. You know, air doesn't have boundaries, so although it's outside the city limits, it still impacts Detroit. And with all of these different polluting
companies, they're loosening a lot of pollution.
Yeah,
they're putting a ton into the air, and Wayne County. Especially
so what are we going to do? Are we going to fine them, or you know, give them a fine, or write them a citation, or
Are
some of the things that we do in a situation like that?
So right now, the Michigan Department of Environmental Quality, who's been getting a lot of heat lately, of course, they do have a system in place for if you have you have to apply for air quality permits in order to have something that puts stuff out into the air. And within those permits, it also calls for, if you violate what's in there, there is potential for a fine. So there have been occasions within my term, and we have only been in office for a year and a couple months, there have been times where Marathon and other companies have actually violated their permit. So one of the things that I'm trying to really do is whenever there's a new permit up before the Michigan Department of Environmental Quality, is get people out to talk about, well, here's my concern about if you're going to approve this permit and what the increase in sulfur dioxide emissions is going to be, what's that impact going to be on my kids, on my asthma, and hearing people's stories of kids that can't breathe unless they have a nebulizer. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's really serious stuff. So, and I think a lot of people know, you know, driving down 75, you see that big Marathon, but it's not just Marathon. It's also DTE, US Steel, AK Steel. And it's something that I'm trying to address through legislation as well. Because one of the things that I realize is our State Department of Environmental Quality does not have any citizen oversight. And 32 other states in the country actually do have forms of citizens, just regular everyday people, having some say in what goes on in that department. So I have a bill that would actually put a citizen oversight commission in place. And we actually had one of these before, but in 1991, Governor Engler abolished it. Mm-hmm. So in my view, it's time to reinstate that.
Excellent.
Okay. Let's give out a number where you can be reach that again, where the people out there in the community can contact you, where they can get where they can reach you. And once again, we're here today with those of you who may be just tuning in. We're here today with State Representative Stephanie Chang, District Number 6. Know your district, know what district you're in, and everything. And once you know what district you're in, begin to contact those city council, whatever district you're in, your state rep district, your city council district, and begin to talk to these people and ask these people questions, because they can bring resources and assistance to you that you will need that will bring comfort to your life.
Absolutely. And the phone number is 313-841-2240. So please call anytime. You know, we have wonderful staff, we love just however we can serve, we would love to do that.
All right. Wonderful, wonderful. You know, what's so great is that the community can reach you Monday through Friday.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Monday through Friday from 9 to 5. Those are beautiful hours. Mm-hmm. And I don't normally, you know, you cannot reach an elected official during those times, you know, because they're working and things like that. But that's a beautiful thing to have a setup like that where the community can come out and talk to someone in those hours from 9 to 5 and get some assistance and get some resources and things. So I just want to let you know that is tremendous.
Thank you.
What do you think about everything, Pastor Donetta?
Oh, I think it's powerful, especially with the environmental legislation you're trying to impact and getting citizens over that.
Yeah.
I think that's very powerful. It's going to help the city because there's a stench that comes from Southwest. You know, it's like, oh, ew, you know, when you drive through there, you know.
Right, a lot of pollution and things like
it's
that.
Really
a lot
bad.
Of companies, a lot of pollution companies and things like that. But with good state representatives like Stephanie Chang, they can begin to come up with solutions and things for that region. And what a show today. What a great, great show today. We're out of time now, and time go by fast when you're having fun. Doesn't it, Stephanie?
Absolutely.
And, you know, I tell you, you know, this is an election year.
It is, yeah.
And, you know, you've been doing a good job, and we just pray, you know, that people like yourself continuously, you know, get back in office and stay in office. I'm Prophet Cedric Banks. I've been your host today. The community shall be restored along with
Prophet Donetta Banks.
And we'll see you next Saturday right here at 2:30 p.m. with another state representative from District Number 4, Rosemary Robinson.
Give her
for your goodness and your
goodness. You're watching W33BY, Detroit, Highland Park, Michigan. The views and opinions expressed on the following show are not necessarily the views and opinions of W33BY, its affiliates, management, or sponsors.